computer. Hey there. So, we are here to pull some Oracle cards for you today.
Indeed.
So I have the goddess deck from Colette Baron Reed. You have the shaman deck from the same person.
That's accurate. I just don't know where it is because I just moved. Today what I was thinking, since we have the goddess deck and only the goddess deck, that we draw a card and we ask a question for the collective, since we are in a time of, you know, like there's a lot of conversation about the collective right now. And, you know, has rugged individualism and capitalism in the way that we've been using capitalism been good for us? And I think we all know the answer to that. And, you know, how can we, as a nation that's like, you know, based in this like rugged individualism, and also in so many other things that we have yet to like really get complete, you know, how are we going to move forward from this? You know, and so maybe that's kind of the question we ask the goddess deck here, is like, I don't know, how do you want to hone that question down or reel it in, Sammy? You got any ideas?
Well, we could ask the deck, what does the collective, when you say the collective, are you speaking globally or of the United States specifically?
I was thinking the United States specifically, but we could go global.
We could go far for each.
Oh, that's a great idea. That's a really good idea. We should, I think one for the nation and one for the world.
Okay.
And so, like, the question being,
What does our nation need to know right now?
Okay.
During this time of pandemic, in order to move forward and progress?
Okay.
Does that sum it up?
Yeah. I think that's a good question.
Okay.
What do we need to know right now?
What do we need to know right now? What does the great goddess want to communicate to us that will help us move past this state of trauma and pandemic that we're facing nationwide? Okay.
Okay.
So I've been shuffling while you've been talking. And I think we should take a moment of silence to hold that question in our minds for the great goddess, and take a moment to focus on it and channel the spirit of the great goddess so that she can guide us as I pull a card for us.
Okay.
I'm gonna take a moment of silence and then I'll shuffle three more times.
Okay. Okay.
I always shuffle three times after asking a question. It feels like the right number for me.
Three is a magical number.
It is. It is. It's what my intuition tells me to shuffle. And these decks are so much about intuition that you really do just have to feel for and listen for what is right. And let the goddess guide you. So I'm feeling around for the card.
Okay. So, illusion is the card that I pulled. I pulled it upside down. So,
what is illusion? You're kind of breaking up.
So I pulled the card illusion.
Illusion.
Ooh, I pulled it upside down, which when we pull a card from a deck, We leave it in the state it is pulled. So if it is pulled upside down, it gives us a different message than if we pull it right side up. So right side up cards get an empowerment message, while upside down cards get an alignment message. So our alignment message for our nation.
Oh man, oh man, you keep breaking up. So this is probably a really powerful message that you're delivering. So just to let you know, I may have to stop you a few times because your audio is kind of coming in and out.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
I find that when really powerful things are happening, technology starts to falter. So here we go.
Here we go.
Illusion.
Illusion. The goddess Maya has come to give you some clarity now. How have you been in denial about your life lately? Have you been chasing after an outcome that eludes you? Do you want to believe in something or someone so badly, perhaps drawn by a potential you hope to see come to fruition, that you've lost your way and given your power over to them? Your alignment task is to summon your courage and be willing to see things as they really are, rather than the way you want them to be. Be honest with yourself. The goddess Maya understands the seduction of illusion, of the illusion of separation. After all, she created the illusion of the individual self. Once the illusion has faded, you are free to choose another path, another way, and other people to connect deeply with. This is a wonderful time to do a self-inventory of your life. How you love, what you believe, who you follow, why you choose to live the way you do.
When the goddess Maya comes to break down illusions and delusions, it is a very auspicious sign.
All right. I mean, it's pretty clear that messaging. Being that the illusion is that we are separate.
Yeah.
And
the illusion, when I was reading it, what I was hearing or what was showing up for me was this illusion of that we can be a libertarian country.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That we don't need each other.
That we don't need each other. When really that is a delusion. You know, we do need each other. We're a massive country. There's so many people. And if everyone is going to be taken care of, and if everyone's voice is going to be heard, which is kind of what our country is built on, is that every voice matters. You know, mm-hmm. That's why we have a vote.
Well, I mean, that's a little bit of the illusion that it's built on, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You know, because, you know, like bringing that in as well, you know, one of the things that we really need to also wake up to is that we aren't living in a real democracy. You know, the outcome of our elections aren't the outcomes of an actual democracy. Now, of course, arguably, if you were to actually live in a real democracy, we'd be voting on every like single piece of legislation and we'd never be able to go to work or whatever. but you know, so it's like a representative democracy, but even with like the way things are run now, you can see that like some simple things like not having a holiday for the elections is silly. That's just a very, very silly thing. And I don't understand it, especially because, you know, we're supposedly like this incredible democracy. And that's the thing that we're supposed to celebrate about this country, but we don't celebrate it by taking a day off on election day. It's crazy. And it's an illusion. Mm-hmm. Also it's been an illusion, I think, for many people that this is a capitalistic system or that because it's not. You know, this isn't real capitalism. We see it in the bailout that is happening right in front of us. That the same thing that happened in 2008, 2009. And it is socialism. And it is socialism for the corporations and the mega rich. And this illusion of, you know, real capitalism is just that. It is an illusion, right? This we live in a state that sucks the money up.
Mm.
So that's another piece that I think we got to get real with. And this whole more of the same rhetoric, because socialism is too scary, is silly. Mm-hmm. Because if you don't think you're already living in something that is socialistic, you are. And it is the kind you don't want to be in. Yeah. So let's talk about how we actually prioritize our money.
Yeah. Your alignment task is to summon your courage and be willing to see things as they really are, rather than the way you want them to be.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's your alignment task, America.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty loaded, and at the same time, it's pretty obvious.
Yeah.
You know, and just, you know, hearing this and looking at the situation we're in and seeing how many people are, you know, in just an economic free fall right now.
I know, right?
I think is a really interesting way for the universe to try to snap us out of this idea that we're doing okay, because we're not.
No, we're not.
Yeah. So.
And I am someone who believes that the universe is always talking to us, always communicating with us in some way. And so, you know, this pandemic isn't an accident. It's not a coincidence.
Right back on the plug of this in. Before I leave y'all. There we go.
Yeah, it's not an accident. It's not an illusion. It's a wake-up call.
Yes, and I think it'll be interesting, not fun in any way, but interesting to watch over the next few weeks how we see the spread of the virus and how we'll be able to relate it to, you know, the fact that our country prioritizes profits and healthcare above actual outcomes. Profits for the corporations, of course, not for the people or for anybody else. Right. So. Yeah.
Okay. You ready to pull for the world?
All right. What does the world need to know?
What does the world need to know during this time?
All right. This one is giving me chills. Like, the United States, I already knew that answer. That was like that's like obvi, right?
I love that the deck always gives us obvious answers, though.
The goddess is like, why are you bitches even asking me this? You know the answer. You're not separate. It's an illusion. Next.
I know, the goddess is a funny bitch.
This one I'm excited because there's a lot of right-wing governments right now, you know, and so when you say stuff like, you know, the pandemic isn't an accident? No, like this is what happens when you have massive amounts of poverty and massive amounts of like corporate greed, you know. Mm-hmm. So this is the outcome of that. And
yeah,
this
isn't an accident. It's a wake-up call.
Because these really authoritarian right-wing governments all over the world are a pandemic, like in and of themselves, right? So we went from metaphorical to literal, that's all.
Yeah, we've been in this pandemic for a while. We're just only actually seeing it so clearly now. Yeah. Okay, so we'll take a moment.
All right, world, what do
you know? Ask the great goddess what the world needs to know right now. Okay, and I'll shuffle 3 times. And while I'm shuffling, I keep my question in my mind, focusing on it, honing it.
Oh, you don't start thinking about what we're gonna have for lunch?
Nope, that would give me a different answer. Okay, a hand I'm feeling for the card. There it is. Oh, it's upside down again. We have another alignment.
Wow, wow, wow. Okay, yep.
Truth.
Truth.
Yes.
I like how one was illusion.
And one is truth.
And we have truth. Okay.
This is the goddess Ma'at, truth. What does the goddess Ma'at have to say to us? Okay. Here we go. The law of karma states that everything comes into balance sooner or later. So trust that in the greater story of your life, all wrongs will get righted. The goddess Ma'at appears with a scale of justice and feather of truth to remind you that you are seeing only one moment in time. The balance of events tips both ways until it comes into coherence with the harmony of the universe. Regardless of this natural rebalancing, it's time to speak up if you see injustice in your world. Ma'at says, in order for you to be truly free, everyone must be free. She offers you the alignment task of considering where you may have hurt someone else and how your unconscious projection of how the world should be may have set you up for transgression, even if you were innocent. This is a time of great unraveling, and nothing meaningful will be accomplished without some effort. Another message for you now is to see behind the words of others, especially when you feel they may be withholding truth or acting without awareness. It's important not to enable this. Tell the truth with as much love as you can, even though denial may be swept away in an awkward moment and everyone feels exposed. It's an important way to move forward with compassion. The goddess Ma'at reminds you that she's a champion for those willing to correct and gives you her full support.
Well,
this is a time of rebalancing.
I know. Well, like, there's, again, the obvious nature sort of doing her thing. Mm-hmm.
Dude, I started tearing up when I read, regardless of this natural rebalancing, it's time to speak up if you see injustice in your world. Ma'at says, in order for you to be truly free, everyone's free. Just that, you know, there is so much lack of freedom in our world. You know, there are so many humans in our, you know, so many people in our race who are, you know, the human race who are just impoverished, who don't have their needs met, who are being taken advantage of, mm-hmm. who are being suppressed and oppressed. And this time of natural rebalancing is making that extremely apparent.
Very apparent. Yeah, it can't be ignored, or it could be. You know, it's just a question of like how bad it's got to get, right, first. But, you know, we get Trump and that wasn't enough, you know, so now we get the pandemic. Maybe this won't be enough either. Mm-hmm. You know, I seriously doubt Bernie Sanders is going to get elected into office because of this, even though I think it's an obvious solution to what we're dealing with. A very obvious, immediate solution that we could take on as a nation. And, you know, so then bring that out to the world. And I feel like,
Global change has to start like somewhere. Global rebalancing has to start somewhere. And, you know, if we're the most powerful nation in the world, then why here?
Right. It's an obvious answer, right? But I mean, maybe it's a little bit of an arrogant answer. Maybe we just need to like get over it. We're not the beacons of like freedom and peace and blah 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 blah. We're the bad guys.
Yeah, we are not the beacons of freedom and peace. So, we love to pretend that we are.
We're really good at it too. When we fly those planes over the ball games. Kills children in Yemen. Isn't that great?
Oh God. I really can't. No. Okay, people are gonna get mad at me for saying this, but I really can't stand the Aaron Water Show.
I can't stand the Aaron Water Show. Let's display all of our war, all of our waste of money.
Dude, it gives me a trauma response to like hear those planes flying over. It's like the collective trauma of everyone that our country has just flattened. It's like I feel it all when I hear those planes and my whole body just
it upsets me immensely. Mm-hmm. Aaron Water Show disgusts me.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm not fun to bring to the Aaron Water Show. No. People have made the mistake of bringing me to the Aaron Water Show, and I tend to make it feel a little down, you know? And so I think that there's a part of me that does believe that there's something that we can do as a nation to bring this, like, this global safety and freedom, you know? To the world, we've definitely not been doing anything that is nearly looks like that in many, many decades. So, or maybe ever. I mean, certainly we've done like peace treaties and, you know, we've done a lot of rebuilding, especially after World War I and World War II. So, like, we've done some good things as a nation, but I don't know since then if there's really been anything to brag about, because, you know, we are the oppressors.
Yeah, we're the country of endless war. Mm-hmm.
And so we can't be free until everybody is free, and we're the ones continuously putting our thumb on everybody also.
Yeah. Yeah.
So how do we?
For you to truly be free, everyone must be free. The alignment task is to consider where you may have hurt someone else and how your unconscious projection of how the world should be may have set you up for a transgression, even if you were innocent. When I think, you know, because we pulled this
makes me think of what an asshole Bernie bro I am.
Well, and this is pulled as a global card. So of course, for us being Americans, we look at, you know, we look at how America projects what the world should be. There's every other country, every other human in every other country who has some projection of what the world should be, the way that it should be. And doing so sets up for transgressions against others. Mm-hmm. You know, when we're so indignant and stop looking to others and hearing what's important to others, there are no solutions. There's only argument. There's only discord. Mm-hmm. Unless everyone can actually be heard, and unless everyone is free to speak, nobody's free.
Okay.
So there's that.
So I guess one of the things that I like that's still there and incomplete for me, mm-hmm. is like, oh, well, okay, so that's what the world needs to know. And I always want to bring it back to like, well, what do you do as an individual? You know? Mm-hmm. And so again, just on a micro level, bringing it back to how you have crossed others.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she says, tell the truth with as much love as you can. Even though denial may be swept away in an awkward moment and everyone feels exposed, it's an important way to move forward with compassion. So what you can do individually is tell the truth with love and compassion.
So what you can do what?
I said, so what you can do is tell the truth with love and compassion.
Okay.
And I'm guessing also encourage others to do the same and listen. Communicate. But, you know, what we reside in a world where the voices that can make the change are the ones that are suppressing others.
Yeah. Yeah.
So for me, what that looks like is banding together, you know, and your massive belief in the internet.
Save us. This pandemic is proving my point immensely. Although, have you heard of the people who are Zooming into like public Zoom conferences and like flashing porn
on yeah.
like screen?
Yep, I've heard of that.
People are hilarious. I would have never thought to do that. What?
It's kind of a dick move. I'm gonna go sexually harass people.
I know. It's just like, who thinks of that? Like, I would have never thought to do that. And so when I heard it, I was like, I had to laugh. I was like, okay, like.
That's a thing.
Of course it is.
Yeah. Ah, well. Oh, the state of the world.
Like, oh my goodness. Oh, well, so that don't flash porn in Zoom meetings. That is not how to free the collective.
No, globally. No that's not it.
That's just how you free a wiener.
Moves. Speaking of freeing a wiener, this dude's still in his car. So just to give a little update for everyone, there is a guy that sits in a VW bug outside of my window. Who I don't think that he lives in his car because, you know, there's not a bunch of stuff in his car and it's a tiny little fucking car, but he's been sitting outside my bedroom window for, what's today? March?
Today's March 31st.
So for like 5 months that I've seen him out there, smokes a lot of cigarettes and pees in cups. I haven't actually...
I mean, smoking cigarettes used to be fun. Mm-hmm. Remember how fun smoking cigarettes used to be?
Yeah. He smokes them weirdly, though. He, like, takes a puff, flicks it out the window. Takes a puff, flicks it out the window. Takes a puff, flick, like...
Is he, like, exhaling?
Pretty much. But while he exhales, he flicks his ash out the window. Like, he flicks his ash very kind of compulsively. Yeah, so he smokes cigarettes really fast. I'm not sure why he's peeing in cups. Every now and again, I see him get out of the car, walk somewhere down the block, come back with, like, another cup and a bag of chips, and then get back in the car. So I think he lives
there. Have you ever seen him sleeping there overnight?
No. No, I only see him awake in the car. He must, like, either live down the street or know someone who does, because he just walks a few buildings down and, like, grabs food and then goes back to his car. But then
he's probably lying to his family about something.
Yeah, well, then he pisses in a cup in his car and opens the door, dumps it in the street, and I'm just very confused.
I'm very confused, too. It's very odd.
Strange thing.
You should let him know to do that with compassion and love, you know.
I do kind of want to go out there and, like, interview him. Like, why do you sit out here in your car?
Yeah, what gives, dude? I'm curious about you. I have a show. It's called Basic Ass Bitches. We'd like to know about you.
We'd like to know. Yeah, I'll interview him for the show one of these days.
I dare you.
Oh, man. You double dog dare me?
I double dog dare you to go over to him and be like, hey, I'm curious. Can I interview you for a show I do? And if you ask why, I just be like, because I've never seen anybody spend so much time in their car. And I'm just really curious. Like, why you spend so much time in your car?
Yeah.
I live in that house. I'm sure you've noticed.
I'm sure you've seen me naked numerous times because you sit outside my windows, which I don't close.
Yeah. I dare you. I double, triple dog dare you.
Okay. One of these days, I will build up the courage. What if he has
you could have one of the guys, like, somewhere hiding, lurking, and making sure that he doesn't, like, weirdly attack you. But dude would probably be more scared of you.
Yeah, I know. I was going to say, oh, I could take him.
No, of course you could. Of course you actually could.
I'll just bring my machete out there with me.
I was going to say, if I was there, I'd lend you my taser, but...
Well, I have a freshly sharpened machete, so...
Of course you do.
Of course. Who doesn't keep a machete in their bedroom?
Well, I have we have an axe, like, hatchet in the kitchen. So, I mean, who doesn't have that? So, but yeah, I'd say, I think you should interview him for the show. I think it'll be great ratings.
Awesome. I'll do that. Oh, goodness. My phone is blowing up, too. We should probably...
Mine's going crazy. I should stop this with you and get on with my work day. The only reason I'm able to continue going right now is because I had a cancellation. So
there you go. Well, I am going to move on with my work day. And I will see you all later.
Thanks for doing this with us.
Thanks for pulling cards with us. Hope you got something for yourself out of it. We'll talk to you later. Bye.